Hello and welcome to California Geology. This is for the winter session 2020 here at West Valley College. I'm your instructor, Robert Lopez, and today I want to look a little bit at the Canvas webpage and go over the syllabus, maybe some of the assignments and how I want you to submit assignments. When you log out in Canvas, you will go to our class, and this is the homepage of our class, and you'll see on the homepage, you'll find my contact information, a little bit of information about the textbook, and this introductory video, which I'll update here for the summer 2020 class. Let's go to the syllabus up here, so we'll get the syllabus tab here. And in the syllabus, this is the same one that I've emailed you on Friday night. You'll want to read through this and go through the details of it, because I do have a syllabus quiz based on, obviously, the syllabus, but also on a little video I have about the California state rock and state mineral and the state fossil. So you'll see that in the introductory video as we go along here. The book that we're using is California's Amazing Geology by Donald Prothero. And this book is a more updated version than we've had before. It's published in 2017. And it really covers all the provinces that we want to look at. And it does introduce some of the fundamentals of geology, like minerals and igneous rocks. But obviously, it's more focused toward the regions, or what we call the provinces, the geomorphic provinces of California. And so in my video lectures and assignments that we'll do more towards the beginning of the course, we'll go over minerals and origin of magmas and igneous rocks and volcanic rocks and sedimentary rocks. And we'll go through the whole rock cycle, and you'll get a good understanding or good background before we can start looking at these provinces of California. Now, for the book, I get the book through Vital Source. So Vital Source book, you can get the book and you can read it online. It's an ebook, and there's a pretty good deal. I think it's $35. Yeah, $35 here for the EPUB. Although I did find a better deal on Amazon here, where you can get the ebook on Amazon till July 17th, when the course ends, for about $26. So that would be a good deal that you can do for this book. And you really will need the book by the end of the second, or really by the second week of classes. Is I do provide the first, or at least the first three chapters that we work on in the first week and a half, which includes chapter 4, which is plate tectonics. So I have those provided for you, and you'll see they'll be in the modules tab here in a moment. But then by the time we start volcanoes, you will really need, that's chapter 6. You'll need that by, here I say June 17th, right? So take a look at the different options. You could also look online if you want to buy a hard copy of it. There are check Amazon. There's lots of people selling the book used for pretty good deals as well, the hard copies. So again, read through this. Let's look for the modules tab, because you'll find that I present the course in the modules tab. And each module is basically going to be either a chapter or a topic that it may include one or two chapters that we'll discuss for this particular assignment. And so, but first, before we start that, let's look at the first module I have up here is textbook, right? So I have those chapters I talked about, and then also I have this open form. So you'll see that for every lecture topic that I do, every video lecture series that I have, these lecture series down here, I have these study questions. And the study questions are based primarily on the videos. So watch the videos, take notes, and then answer the study questions. And the reason these study questions are important, I use those to write the exams. And for example, for the geomorphic provinces quiz here, these questions are primarily coming from the study questions, right? So if you have these answered, you should do very well on the quizzes and exams. So anyways, going back to this open form, if you are stuck on a problem, you can post a question to the whole class. And you can sort of almost treat it like a group study session there, where you can post questions and query other students about maybe a question from the study guide that you didn't understand, or maybe there's an assignment you didn't quite get. Although what I plan to do for this summer session is I will have at least one Zoom meeting per week, probably on Wednesdays at 10. I think that's the time I'm going to allocate. And I can help you with these study questions, or if you're not understanding an assignment or how to submit assignments, which I'll get to here in a moment. But anyways, that's a little open form where you can kind of work together as a study group there. Now for again, as I was saying, each module, so the course is going to be presented here, each module will have this learning guide. And in their learning guide, you'll see the list of things I want you to do to complete this module. And you'll see that in the course, in the syllabus, we have bi-weekly due assignments. In other words, there'll be a group of assignments due on Wednesday nights, and then another group due on Sunday nights, right? So twice a week you'll have assignments. For example, for provinces module, they'll be due June 10th, right? So that'll be on Wednesday. You'll see that this also will include the syllabus quiz here, right? So that's the syllabus quiz that you'll take. And again, you'll take that after watching this introductory video that I'm gonna update here, plus this one here on the state rock, state mineral, gem and fossil, right? So you wanna look at those, take notes on them, and then take the syllabus quiz. For chapter one, I have a reading quiz based primarily on the reading. So you'll wanna read either the PDFs I have for you up here that are provided, or if you have the book, obviously you'll read the book. And then you'll see that for each topic, I have these video lectures. I posted these on YouTube, and I talk about the different provinces of California here. And so you'll wanna watch these videos. And the key thing is to take notes, because remember, the answer to those study questions that I use for quizzes and exams will be from those video lectures. So I have a whole series of video lectures. So that's the chapter one, the provinces and introduction. But you can see that also due on Wednesday will be the minerals work, right? So for the minerals, again, you'll click on the learning guide. And this is take this as like your checklist of what you need to do. I need to read chapter two, at least a portion of chapter two that deals with minerals. Take that chapter two minerals reading quiz, Canvas quiz, based on the reading assignments. I have these little geode animations, and the only thing about these are they're kind of fun to watch because they're sort of interactive, although it requires flash on your computer. So you'll have to be able to get a device that can use flash to run these. And then there's a quiz based on that interactive tutorial. Then here I have watch my video lectures, take notes, and then answer those study questions, because remember, I'm gonna put those study questions, or at least not all of them, a good portion of those on the first exam. So you'll see here is a lecture. Well, let's look at the online lecture series here first. And again, here I have, I'm talking about mineral structure, the silicate minerals, the physical properties of minerals, how we identify minerals. So we do all these different types of diagnostic interpretations of the properties of the minerals, including scratching and sniffing and to determine their softness and odor, right? Some, especially with sulfur, will give you a characteristic odor. After that, you'll see that I have the study questions. And so these study questions, I'll take a subset of these, basically put them on the exam. And the answer to these questions are from the video lecture. So that's why it's important to take notes. And you'll see that for the exams, about maybe 65-70% of the exam is a multiple choice or matching problems. But I do have about 30% or a little bit more where we're looking at short answers or short essay questions, right? Now, so that's a little bit about the minerals. And then for the geode animation, let's click on this here. And when we click on this, you'll have to click again here, and it'll take you to an external website.
Earth's crust is a source for a wide variety of useful and essential minerals.
So here what you're seeing, you'll click through these different panels, right? And each panel will give you a little introduction.
Most people know that copper is used for electrical wiring and gold is used for jewelry. But most people are not aware that the main ingredient in cosmetics is a powdered form of the mineral talc.
You'll see that talc has a hardness of one. It's one of the minerals on our hardness scale. But anyways, you'll go through these. Let's see if there's one where they ask some questions. So minerals are defined as naturally occurring inorganic solids that possess an orderly internal structure and a well-defined chemical composition. That is true. And gold is a mineral. So usually I talk about the four-part definition of the mineral, and then they ask, is gold a mineral? Yes. Is this right? I got it correct. So anyways, you'll see there's some interactive play that goes along with this. So after you complete the different parts of the tutorial here, you'll see that there's a quiz on this. And you'll see in the syllabus that I allow you to take the quizzes twice, and I give you the better score of the two attempts. And that's true for all the quizzes, except for the exams. The exams, you only get one try, right? So for exams, I don't have a time limit, so I give you unlimited time. So what you want to do is really go into these modules, and then just you'll see the breakdown. I have the whole course published. It's ready to go. I have to add a couple things here and there. I think on volcanoes, and I have some new material on the Sierra Nevada that I want to talk about. And I think I have a new article on the Hayward Fault, because the Hayward Fault's kind of overdue for an earthquake. And living here in the Bay Area, that's really the most dangerous fault that we have in the San Francisco Bay Area. But I'll have all that worked out by the end of the first or second week. But you'll see that the first couple of weeks here, you're good to go, and you'll see all the due date assignments. In fact, what we'll do, let's look at the student view, because let's see what you see. And I want to point something out on the syllabus. So this is the student view where you would see, you would log in, you kind of see what assignments are going to be due coming up here. And then let's look at the syllabus here. And on the syllabus, after you read through this, you'll see at the bottom, well, I have the breakdown of how I'm presenting the course here. I do have the exam schedule. I don't think I included this part in the syllabus that I sent you, but here's the exam schedule. And these are the closing dates. So the exams are already published. You can take them anytime, but obviously you want to do the work, prepare yourself before you take these exams. Also, I want to point out here is at the bottom in the student view, at least what you'll see kind of what everything's due. So this is another way of kind of looking like a learning guide is what's due by June 10th. All these things are due June 10th. June 14th, a couple of things on plate tectonics. June 17th, this is what's due. Oh, here, exam one, June 19th, that's a Friday. And so you kind of have the whole course broken down here, right? So everything is set up and you can kind of gauge yourself to see, for example, the coast ranges where we live, I have a number of assignments. So this might be a little bit of a heavier week. So you'll see that the week before, it's a light week. So maybe you start knocking some of these out early because you have a lighter load here on July 8th. The other thing I wanted to point out is for submitting assignments. So here is an assignment that you'll do later on called the San Andreas Fault Observatory at Depth. And you'll read the little article I posted here. I got this from the Mercury News, the San Jose paper. And I just kind of copied the text and put it in here. But you'll see at the bottom, I have some questions I want you to answer. And so some of the assignments will be like this. And the way to submit, and we look at, so for example, this person just wrote it on her notebook paper and took a picture. But the key thing I want you to do, if you're doing it this way, many people don't have a scanner, I want you to make sure it's readable. I need to be able to read this and maybe take multiple pics. You can zoom in more. In fact, I'd prefer this. Maybe if you used a QR scanner that had a PDF scanner on there, you can take a picture with your phone with a QR scanner. And in our Zoom meeting, maybe I'll talk a little bit more about how to do this. So that's a good way to do it. Or this next student here did it in a Word file, which is wonderful. That's easy to read, and I can read through that. And so you can, and then I think I even had a student, and this student did it just as a text entry. So just in the submission assignment tab, they just wrote the questions and answers right there, right? So anyways, that'll be available to you, or at least some ways to submit. You make sure when you're submitting these assignments, they're clear and that I can read them. All right, well, let's stop here for now.